Good morning, students. Now let's know about the second ruler of Sangam dynasty of Vijayanagar Empire. The Harihar was the elder brother, so he got first to rule in Vijayanagar Empire. After him, Bukka got the chance to rule on Vijayanagar Empire, and he ruled from the period of 1356 to 1377. He was very good administrator and a very good scholar also. He was a very powerful ruler. That's why he got the title also. The title was Vidman Pratisthapaka, means the person who shows the way to study Vedas. He was a very good administrator. That's why he adopted a way for a joint administration. ज्वाइंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन मीन्स संयुक्त रूप से साम्राज्य चलाना. इसका मतलब कि टू हैव दैट टू टेक द कॉन्फिडेंस ऑफ ऑल द ऑफिशियल्स बिलोंगिंग फ्रॉम ऑल द कास्ट क्रीड और क्लास और रिलीजन. एंड ही ऑल्सो डिड द सेम थिंग एंड ही डिसाइडेड इन 1346 टू डू द ज्वाइंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. एक संयुक्त रूप से राज्य चलाने की बात उसने डिसाइड कर ली थी 1346 में. एंड आफ्टर दैट ही डिसाइडेड टू स्प्रेड द फेम ऑफ विजयनगर एम्पायर इन द नेबरिंग कंट्रीज ऑल्सो. ही वॉन्टेड दैट नेबरिंग कंट्रीज ऑल्सो शुड नो हाउ द विजयनगर एम्पायर इज ग्रोइंग एंड हाउ मच गुड बिल्डिंग्स एंड मॉन्यूमेंट्स एंड टेम्पल्स इट इज हैविंग एंड विच काइंड ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इट इज हैविंग, विच काइंड ऑफ लाइफ स्टाइल इट इज हैविंग and what kind of architectural development they are having. Because we all know that Vijayanagar was a very developed city and it was known for its architectural designs, architectural buildings and temples also. So for this purpose, he appointed a group of ambassadors, means usne ek dut mandal banaya, and he sent that group of ambassadors to the China. And he sent it in 1374, he sent them to China to spread the fame of the Vijayanagar Empire. And after that, he decided to expand his empire also. And for that purpose, he attacked on Madurai. It was also known as Madura, but nowadays it is also known as Madurai. And in 1377, he attacked on Madurai and he included Madurai in Vijayanagar Empire because he defeated the king of Madurai. Then he was inspired by this victory, so he thought that he should expand his empire more. And then there was a war between Bukka and Bhumashah first. But in this war, no one could get the victory. Bhumashah first was the ruler of Bahmani Raj, and then he could not get the victory here. There was a tie. Tie means no party, yani no ruler, means not Bhumashah Pratham and not Bukka could get the victory. So they signed a treaty. And according to this treaty, the land between the Krishna River and Tungbhadra River, land between the Krishna and Tungbhadra River was given to the Bukka. And it was included in the Vijayanagar Empire. The second and the most important thing was that Bukka adopted the way of religious freedom. Now what is religious freedom? Means the people belonging from Jainism, then Buddhism, Christianity, do the work in the in his empire also. Then next is Krishna River and Tungabhadra River. We are talking about this. So this river became the territorial line, and one side there was a Brahmani kingdom and the other side was a Vijayanagara kingdom. And after this war, this river became the territorial line. And the land between two rivers, that is Tungabhadra and Krishna River, that was given to Bukka.